Hey there, Mercedes here from PrettyWebz.com, and today we're working on a fur brush Photoshop tutorial. This is a basic fur that we're going to create using a basic Photoshop default brush and then just making some adjustments to it. I'm going to go through all of the adjustments that I'm going to use to create this brush, and then I'm going to show you how to make adjustments to the color, direction, stiffness, all of that stuff. Let's go ahead and get started. I want to show you what the brush looks like. Now you can see right here that I have these two brown colors. So I'm doing them very high contrast like this just to give you an idea of what this brush looks like and so that it shows up on camera. Of course, you can adjust these to anything that you want. What I usually do is I'll just, you know, grab a screenshot of the fur that I want and then just pick out colors from that. For this one, we're going to use these pretty high contrast colors, and I just want to show you the brush that we're going to be making. So I'm going to just do this like tail type thing here. I wanted to show you the direction of this. You can see that as I draw, this fur is just taking the direction that I'm drawing, and then it's picking up on both of these two colors here, and you can see how much dimension that these colors are adding to this right here. And then we're also going to work on this exterior, this area right here, the stiffness of this. So we're going to go ahead and get started. I'm going to show you how to create the brush. So I'm going to come in here to my brushes. If you don't have this little icon here and this doesn't come up for you, you can just come here to Window and click on Brushes, and that will come up for you there. Before we get started with any of the settings, we need to make sure that our flow up here is at 5%. This is going to be one of the most important things for this brush. So I'm going to show you the brush, and then I'm going to show it to you with a flow at 100%, and you're going to see the big difference in the style of the brush. So you can see right there what a drastic change these are, and that's because when the flow is at 5%, it's giving you more of a blend between all of these brush tips that are being laid down on the canvas right here. So just make sure that your flow is at 5% and you should be okay. Now when you save this brush, you're gonna have to save it with that flow at 5%, otherwise you're gonna come back to them and you're gonna see something like this and wonder what the heck happened there. So just make sure that you're saving it with these settings as well. So when you come in here, you have all of your settings taken care of, your brush settings, you know, everything is good. You're gonna come here to the three lines. You'll choose New Brush Preset, and you wanna include the tool settings but not the color. So just make sure that you do include those tool settings, or what you've created today, this one, is actually going to look like this. So you can name it whatever you want, but I just wanted to point that out, that you will have to save those tool settings in order to get this. This right here is the brush that I already created with all of the settings, but I did use a Photoshop default brush to create it. So what I'm going to do is come up here to Legacy Brushes. If you're in Photoshop 2020 and you don't see this, you'll have to come here to the three little bars right there. Click on that and then choose Legacy Brushes, and that will load all of those brushes in for you. So we're going to come in here to Legacy Brushes, Default Brushes, and we're going to scroll down until we find the Grass Brush. So this is the dune grass. We want just the regular grass, which is the one with the three. The dune grass has the one. You can use either, but I just like this one. It comes out a little bit thicker. So we're gonna use the grass brush. So if you're starting this on your own, you're gonna start here with this brush. For me, I'm just gonna grab the brush I already created just because I want to show you the settings on it, and you can see just by the outline of this that it is that grass brush. And I'm going to come over here to my brush settings. That's this little icon right here. If you don't have it there, again, here in brush settings, you can just click on that right here in brush tip shape. So for this one, I'm going to make this 200 pixels. My spacing is going to be 1%, and that's it for this part right here. And I'm going to come in here to shape dynamics. I'm going to leave my size jitter at 16%. My control is pen pressure. Minimum diameter, zero angle jitter. I have that all the way up to 100%. And this right here is very important. Make sure that you have initial direction selected. That's what's going to give us that, where it's kind of following where I'm taking the pencil. Roundness jitter, you can leave at zero, control off, and then everything else is going to be off for that. Now we're going to move over here to scattering. For scattering, you can leave both axes unchecked, 0%. Control is going to be pen pressure. Our count is six. Our count jitter is zero. And I'm going to show you the difference that the count makes. I'm going to bring this down to one. And you can see the difference there. So if you want to bump this up even more, you can do that as well. I'm going to go ahead and leave mine at six. But you can see how sparse it is when you don't have that selected. So make sure that your count is up, a pretty good number for your count. Now we're going to move over here to texture. Now for the texture, we're using another Photoshop default pattern in here. And when you click on that, you'll see where all of these are. So we're here in Photoshop defaults, legacy patterns, and more. If you don't have this because you are updated to the Photoshop 2020 or higher, then you'll have to actually manually come in here and do that as well. So I'm going to come here to Window and I'm going to click on my patterns. That will bring something similar to this. You're not going to have all of this stuff here, but what we want to load is this one right here, the Photoshop defaults. Once this window is up, you'll just click on the three little lines there and choose legacy patterns and more. Just click on that. And that's going to bring up your legacy patterns right here. So if you click on Photoshop defaults, it's going to be right there, legacy patterns and more. Or it might be outside of this. I might have moved it. I'm not sure. But anyhow, just look for this folder right here, legacy patterns and more, when you're inside of the brush settings. So we're going to click on that. And it's going to bring up something similar to that patterns menu. Right here, you can see I have the Photoshop defaults. I'm right here, legacy patterns and more. I'm choosing legacy patterns. And then inside of legacy patterns, I'm coming down here to patterns. And I am using this one right here. This is called clouds. It is the third to last inside of this patterns folder. So we're going to go ahead and click on that. Just click outside of there to get out of that one. Our scale is 1%. So basically here, all I did was take these sliders all the way down on all of these. Scale, brightness, contrast, everything is here. So brightness, -150, contrast, -50. Texture, each tip is selected. Your mode is height, and the depth is 100%. Depth jitter, zero. Control is off for the texture. We're going to come here to dual brushes. We don't really need dual brushes. Yeah, you're going to get pretty much the same thing. So I'm going to go ahead and leave dual brushes off for this one. Dual brushes will come in handy if you're trying to make like spotted furs and other things like that. But for this one, we don't need it. So I'm going to come in here to color dynamics. This is very important for this brush. So this is going to control the coloring and dimension of the fur just by, these colors that you have chosen here. So for color dynamics, I'm going to make sure that apply per tip is selected. My foreground background jitter is at 100%. Control is going to be off. And then I have all of these set to zero. So hue, saturation, brightness, and purity are all at 0%. I'm going to go ahead and turn transfer off to it. I think we need that for this brush. And then just make sure that buildup is selected, smoothing is selected, and protect texture is selected. So this is our brush. I just wanted to show you a few things with the coloring. So if you come here to color dynamic, so I'm going to show this to you in black and white. So this is my jitter at 100%. So it's more like a gray color. But if you wanted a darker fur, you can come in here to color dynamics and maybe set this to 50%. and then that'll give you a darker color. It's just a matter of working with the foreground background color. If you want that foreground color to be more prominent, then you know, just bring it down. You can bring it down even more and you're gonna get a lot of that dark color. But I go about 50% just to make that foreground color a little more dominant. So you have that, this is at 50%. And then if I make the white the dominant color, now this right here, the white becomes the dominant color here. And if I take that back up and I have my white there, you can see I'm just going back to that gray color. So the color dynamics is going to be very important for this. So I'm going to leave this at 16 just to make a reference here. And then I'm going to take the size jitter up to about 60%. And you can see how much looser the fur starts to get as I do that. So this will, you know, help you get a different style as well. So you can save different variations of these brushes. And once you're happy with one, you can just come over here to the little three bars there and choose new brush preset, name it whatever you want, and then do that for each iteration of the brush. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to like and share it. And if you like the content that I put out on this channel, please make sure to subscribe so that you don't miss another video. And as always, go over to prettywebz.com for more design resources and tutorials. Until next time, thanks for watching.